What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen Bagen from another Rebirth 1999 video. And for today, let's talk about the 6-star selector in Rebirth 1999. Do you guys even know that there is a 6-star selector? Yes, there is, but there is a catch. It is not for free. You need to spend real money in order for you to get your hands on it. And so, should you buy the 6-star selector? First and foremost, I just want to make this clear. I am not encouraging you to spend into the game. I am not even paid to do that one. So let's be clear about that one. So let's now talk about the 6-star selector. Should you buy it? You can find it here in the bank at the cost of 30 bucks. Where is that one? It's called Souvenir of Companionship. As at the time of recording, we still have 28 days before this one will be gone. It is a bundled one, a 6-star selector bundled with a multi worth of summon, one multi's worth of summon with 10 unilugs here. And if you will see here the friendship in suitcase, there are 6-stars that you can choose here. You can only choose one. Now, if you decide to spend into the game and bought this one, who are the best 6-star choices for you? In my honest opinion, the best choice that you can pick here is always going to be Tooth Fairy. Yeah, Tooth Fairy, if you don't have Tooth Fairy, in my honest opinion, I don't have Tooth Fairy. I am really, really tempted to buy this one. I will still hold on to my decision before I bought this one, because if you guys don't know, I am a completely F2P in this game. Yeah, I have not bought anything. I have not bought the monthly pack. I have not bought the battle pass or any skins or any paid skins out there. But I'm really at my wit's end because I still haven't gotten my hands on Lucy. Yeah, still haven't summoned Lucy. I lost my 6-star through Unli last time. So yeah, I'm really on the fence right now whether I should be buying this one. And I don't have Tooth Fairy. Tooth Fairy is proven to be, is tested to be a really, really good character. And up to this point, she's still pretty, pretty darn good. She's pretty meta. Or you might want to call it meta. I don't think there is a meta in Rebirth 1999. Every stages are hard, not really the hardest stages, but most of the stages can be cleared by even low rarity characters. But 6 stars makes them really easy, or it makes you have some easier time in clearing them. The available 6 stars here are Sotheby, A Knight, Regulus, Voyager, Eternity, Drubis III, Lilia, Unli, Centurion, Medicine Packet, Miss New Babel, Melania, Pickles, Tooth Fairy, Jessica, Shamane, Kala Bawana, 37, 6, Patodea, Ezra, Getian, and Semmelweis. Everyone has Semmelweis. So she is already a big cross here because we get Semmelweis for free, right? Sotheby is already pretty much outdated. She is already power creep by Vile. What is her name? I forgot her name. Sotheby is already power creep by Villa, not Vile. Villa, yeah. Sotheby is already power creep by Villa. And in harder content, Sotheby cannot sustain anymore. Yeah, but she's still pretty good in a poison dedicated team. But other than that one, Sotheby is not really a good choice to pick here in the 6-star selector. But if you are a Sotheby simp, there's no stopping you in getting Sotheby here. A Knight is still not really in the good spot. Probably around mid-tier category. Regulus, if you're a fan of Regulus, you might want to be choosing her, but no, she's not really a good choice here, because there are a lot of good characters to choose here. Voyager, also already power creep. Eternity, same. Drubis the Third, already power creep, but still very very strong. A really really strong control character. Control DPS character. Lilia, already power creep, not really desirable anymore. And Lee might still see some uses. Still a really strong support. Centurion already got power creep, really really hard. Because DPS characters are easily replaceable, but for support characters, they are really hard to come by. And I will be suggesting that if you're going to be purchasing this one, I suggest go for the OP support characters, just like Tooth Fairy. Medicine Packet, a good healer, but there are better characters to choose here. Miss New Babel, I don't know about Miss New Babel. I haven't checked her kit yet. Melania is still a strong character, but there are already better DPS characters than her. Pickles, a really good support. You might want to consider Pickles, but Pickles is already outdated. Pickles is one of those early 6-star banners that you've got when the game was just starting in global. Tooth Fairy, up to this point, Tooth Fairy is still very, very strong. I think Tooth Fairy is going to be the number one choice here if we are talking about utility-wise. Tooth Fairy is very, very strong. Jessica, a strong DPS character in the Plant Aplatus. Shamane is a good support also for the Beast Aplatus. Probably between Abyss Aplatus element, Shamane or Getian. Both of them are both really good support, so either pick one of the two if you're lacking in some support in the Beast Aplatus. Kala Buana, I don't have her. Yeah, I don't have her. I think she is a mineral DPS. But if you already have the limited character, the mineral one, Jun Yangxi. I'm always forgetting her name. You don't really need to pick any mineral DPS characters here because Jun Yangxi is very very strong up to this point. The very first limited character, by the way. 37 is still very very strong. If you're lacking some really good Star Aplatus sa DPS, 37 might be the best choice for you. But if you already have something like I'm always forgetting their name. I'm sorry about that one. This one. Winsong. Yeah, Winsong. A really, really recent character. I forgot her name. Winsong is broken in the Star Aplatus DPS. So if you have already Winsong, you don't need 37. Because Winsong already fulfills the role for that one. 6 is a really, really strong support. Yeah, up to this date, 6 is still one of those MVP support characters in my lineup, in my team. Pair her with Why am I having some Isolde? Yeah, 6 plus Isolde is a deadly combination. Yeah, Isolde plus 6 is a really really deadly combination. If you have Isolde, then having 6 in your lineup is also a really good thing. Spatodeya, very very strong if you have Isolde. Only choose Spatodeya if you have Isolde, because Spatodeya shines when you have a good support for the burn, which is Isolde. Ezra, a good I think Ezra is a healer, right? Healer in the Star Aplatus. Between Ezra and Tooth Fairy, I will gladly choose Tooth Fairy over Ezra. Getian, as I've said, the same like Shamane. Both are support in the Beast Aplatus. And Semmelweis, everyone has Semmelweis, so do not choose Semmelweis. So my top pick for this one is going to be Tooth Fairy, followed by 6, followed by either Spatodeya or 37. If you're missing those really strong DPS in your team. So yeah, for at the cost of $30, you get a 6-star selector and a Unilag. I think this one is worth it if you're a spender. But if you are a F2P, just stay F2P. Do not be swayed by my words. Even though I am myself is going to be swayed by my words. Because this one is a really, really good deal. Compare it to other gacha games that has some form of a 6-star in their bundle. Let's just say Arknights. Arknights, in every anniversary, if I remember correctly, they have a bundle of 6-star for the cost of $30 also. But that one is not a selector. That one only has a chance to get the featured character there. I think there is a 3 or 4 characters in that bundle. So it's not a 100% of your own choosing. Compare it to a Reverse 1999, where you are going to be choosing the character that you want or that you need. Plus a multi's worth of summon is already a good steal. This one is a good bundle. So if you are a spender, that one is worth it in my honest opinion. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.